We beat them?
Yeah.
Damn. And Jordan was playing? That's crazy. Wait, hold on. What happened?
That didn't count.
That didn't count?
That was off
the buzzer. Wow. That's crazy. What year was this?
1996.
These jerseys are hard too. That's crazy. I didn't know that was Jordan Jordan.
Exactly.
Yeah. That's Jordan Jordan. How did Jordan feel after that? We should get Jordan here. Anyone have his number?
This is a nice setup. Wow.
That's a great shot right there. Wow. Yeah.
Where do I sit? Is it like this?
My son got the Concords on.
Ooh.
I was out in right field at Sky Dome Rogers Center way back then, and I was at that game, so I can only speak to it as a fan. And to have a team finally in my city, in my backyard, to cheer for, to get behind, just seeing that first year and all those little moments that came.
It's like people talking about, like, oh, we're getting a team, and how that was such a big, I didn't get how big of a deal it was because I always watched basketball. That was when I realized, like, not everybody was watching basketball at the time.
I think people were excited because it was new, but they didn't know. They were taken aback. They had no clue what it was going to be like. I think they took to it really quickly, but they were, at the start, they were pretty mystified. Like, they're playing music during the game? They don't do that in hockey.
Like, that's honestly one of the few games that I remember from the first season. Probably the first game against the New Jersey Nets in that game, and I don't really remember anything else.
The hottest ticket in Toronto today at the Sky Dome, Michael Jordan, Scottie Pippen, and the Bulls against the Toronto Raptors.
I think Michael Jordan wants 70 wins. He has 3 championship rings, scoring titles, all-star awards, but he wants to be remembered as having the best team of all time.
When Chicago came to town, everywhere they went, it was a circus. It's like the Lakers with Magic, you know, the Celtics, Bird, but it was even bigger with Jordan and the Chicago Bulls at that time.
Everybody knew it would be a big crowd because it was the 72-10 Bulls. It was Jordan. It was like Beatlemania.
Like looking up to the 500 level, and there were people up there. Like, the game must have been a rumor from there.
I've met 200,000 people that claim they were there. Well, I don't know. I don't know how many people. They weren't 150,000 people there, but everyone claims they were there because it was that big a moment.
I think the 96 Bulls are the greatest collection of basketball talent to ever be put on the hardwood. And let's be honest about the 96 Raptors. I love the Raptors, but the 96 Raptors weren't good.
Chicago was 60-7 or 60-8 coming into the game. They lost as often as I paid the mortgage, once a month, twice a month. And here they come to Toronto, who had, I don't know, Toronto had maybe 17, 18 wins. They only ended up with 21 for the year. It was one of those Sunday afternoon in Toronto games, which later they became infamous because guys would come to Toronto and enjoy the nightlife.
Yeah, they were up pretty late. And we were, a lot from what Ron Harper told me, he said, T, we didn't get in until about 6, 7 in the morning. When we got to shoot around, no one did anything. When we got to the arena for pregame, he said, you notice you guys had both courts pregame. He said, everybody was still messed up from the night before. I was like, yeah, they got them.
The thing that I remember about the game sitting courtside is how hard the Bulls played. Like there was some pride in there from Jordan, Pippen, Harper, you know, Steve Kerr made big shots.
I actually watched the game on TV and I was like, how's this happening?
That night was special. I don't know what was going on or what was in the air, but one thing we did was play hard for 48 minutes. And you can catch people sleeping if you play hard for 48 minutes. And that day, we had it going, we had it clicking.
This is going to sound kind of foolish, but that really wasn't surprised that the game was that close. The Raptors had lost games by 9, 9, and 3 points to Chicago. They were in every game.
You take a guy like Damon Stoudemire, who, you know, he came up here, played his butt off, and, you know, and really in a pretty dark period for the Raptors. You know, I think any player in their career is craving that moment. And for Damon Stoudemire, you know, he went off for 30 points. He would lead the charge in the comeback fourth quarter in front of, you know, as many people as ever I've seen a basketball game in Canada at one in one place.
And, you know, everybody had huge games that day, right? Damon had a huge game. Tracy had a huge game. The thing I remember was, I think Steve Kerr was the one who took the shot at the end, had a chance to win the game.
And Michael taking, mishandling the ball back to Kerr, to Pippen, back to Kerr, missing that shot.
You never feel like you got it in hand when you got Michael Jordan on the floor. It's just, you just don't. You know that he always has that last minute heroic situation where he can just take over a ball game and just snatch it from you. It's like snatching a candy from a baby.
And Michael got the ball in the corner.
From an angle that you would only take a bank shot from in horse, banked it off the top corner of the backboard, it went in.
Just after the buzzer. It knocks it down just after the buzzer. And I think people at that time were still in shock. Wait, we won? You won? It didn't count? Because Michael Jordan, he ruined everybody's dreams, right? I mean, you have a great game, you're right there, he makes it, and it ends your night.
Our hearts dropped for a second. And then when we saw the official wave it off, then it was just pure, it was like we won a world championship. It was like the Raptor Parade, pretty much. You know, we were celebrating, the fans were celebrating, the city went crazy that night.
You know what really stands out to me from that clip? There's a referee baseline underneath the basket there, and he doesn't do a thing. Like, he doesn't signal no basket, he doesn't signal it's made, doesn't do a thing. He's just standing there like he's a bystander. And if I'm wrong announcing all this, boy, am I gonna look like a fool.
I didn't really take in the magnitude of the situation. I just knew we beat Michael Jordan, because my dad was just jumping up and down. We beat Michael Jordan, we beat Michael Jordan.
To beat the Bulls was a way for the Raptors to kind of sneak into, you know, the popular sports world, because they weren't reporting on the Raptors losing to the Timberwolves on a nightly basis.
It was a stamp in Raptor history that was needed. We had a couple of wins that year where you saw a future. You need that. You need that to get everybody's attention in the city and to gain those fans early.
It was one game, one night, and the Raptors put it all together. And for the young fan base at the time, it's something that provided them this lift, right? Of, hey, yeah, you know, we're in this thing, right? And that's what those moments are, one of the reasons why they're so significant, because it provides hope.